welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to do something that you have probably not seen me do before, a fill, because I usually don't do them because I just love how a fresh set looks. Like, it's something about a fresh set that's just amazing to me, but I need to work on doing fills because I've only done one maybe once. But so we're gonna do a fill in with the sparkly pink poly gel. I left my prep in here. I just sped it up a little bit so you guys can see. This is actually how I take my nails off. I file them down as thin as I can and then I soak them. But I'm just really filing off the top coat and any bulk or anything, the leftover little things from the gems when I got them off and everything. And I'm also gonna show you how I take off the sparkly gel polish, and then we're gonna do the fill. Y'all, this dust was flying everywhere. I did order a dust collector, and you guys will see that when it comes. I'm gonna do a big AliExpress haul. I have ordered a lot of stuff, and I'm gonna wait till everything comes in so I can kind of give you an idea about like time frames and stuff, because AliExpress takes forever. Y'all, I'm tired doing these nails. It's at night and I'm thirsty. That's why Dr. Pepper makes this appearance. Pay, I ordered this primer and dehydrator kit off Amazon. Guys, look at this brush when I put it up to the camera. The bristles are just going everywhere. You can only see two on the camera, but it's like quite a few of them. But I'm gonna fix it and make it work somehow. But an important thing with poly gels, or just doing any type of nails, poly gel, acrylic, dip, 1-2-3 go nails, or the jelly tips, whatever you need, prep and primer. Make sure you get all the oils off. Make sure you get all the dust and things off, because that's what'll cause lifting and nails popping off, which is why a lot of people complain about when they go to the nail salons, because they're not staying on, they're popping off. A lot of nail salons are just trying to get you in and out, and they're not doing the prep the way they should, so your nails do pop off or break within, you know, a couple of days or whatever. So your prep work and everything is so important if you want your nails to stay on. Like, if you're just doing a set of nails to have them on just for like a day or so or a couple days, don't worry about your prep, because they'll come off. But if you're wanting them to last, you do have to do good prep with primer and dehydrator. Broke one of my nails, so I'm going to use a dual form to fix that one, and then the rest are going to be just like a regular fill. As I'm a glutton for punishment, we are going to try these foils again. And yeah, once again, fail. It's a little better than the last time, but still not what I wanted. So you know what we're gonna do? We're just gonna pull out this Beatles gel polish. We're gonna get my favorite hot pink and we're just gonna color over it. And then that's just what's gonna happen. Okay, so you can still kind of see the flower through the polish. So what I'm gonna do is put some builder gel on my finger and then go over it with some top coat. And then without curing, I'm gonna go in and start putting my stones on. And this is the best way I feel to keep my stones on. Like right now, I haven't lost one stone, but what you'll see later on in the video is I use just top coat on my other hand. And right now, I only have like 4 stones left out of 8 or 9. So this builder gel top coat seems to be so far the best way I have found to keep my stones on. guys, so these are the finished nails. At first, I didn't like them when I took them outside and they sparkled. Oh my gosh, I love them. I'm not a big fan of like blinged out nails, but I think I kind of like this one. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and see you in the next one.